The Wall Street Journal is reporting that the president repeatedly asked the Ukrainian counterpart, his Ukrainian counterpart, rather, to investigate Joe Biden's son. Joining us right now is Republican Congressman from California, Devin Nunes. He is the ranking member of the House Intel Committee. He also sits on the House Ways and Means Committee. And Congressman, it's always a pleasure to have you.
Great to be here.
Thanks
with you
so much for joining us. So you're going to be there. Obviously, you're the ranking member of Intel. What are you expecting from Joseph McGuire?
Well, it'll be interesting to see what his thoughts are as to why this information should not be provided to Congress. Most people believe it's because it was a privileged conversation that the president had with another foreign leader, which historically we've never received those. Now, I'm all for receiving privileged conversations that our leaders are having with foreign leaders, as long as we're going to get all the conversations that happened between Vice President Biden and the Ukrainians, Barack Obama and Putin, Barack Obama and all the other world leaders. So this really opens Pandora's box. If it's going to be game for the legislative branch of government to get all these privileged conversations that our leaders have, it needs to be more than just President Trump. We need to get all the conversations that our leaders have with foreign leaders.
I mean, once again, you put on, you know, MSNBC or CNN, and it's all about this. Once again, yeah. The media is all over this as if the president did something improper. Did the president do anything improper?
Right. This has all the hallmarks of the Russia hoax, right? It's the same. Let's just go through it. Something leaks out that there's something bad that happened. And then it goes, it's the same reporters that report on it, the same exact reporters that reported on the Russia hoax report on it. Then you move forward, and what happens? Then supposedly they come and testify the night before they testify. Then this whistleblower, who supposedly doesn't want anybody to know who this person is or what information they have, well, it's spilled all over the pages of the Washington Post the day before the ICIG, the Inspector General for the Intelligence Community, comes in and briefs us.
Yeah.
So this is, it looks, whoever came up with this scheme, because it looks like it was somebody trying to deflect what Biden did back in 2015, okay, he's definitely got some questions that he needs to answer as to what was he doing talking to the Ukrainian leadership at the time when
right.
his son has a contract. We want to get to the bottom of that also. But this scheme seems to have backfired on Biden. I mean, Biden's already dropping in the polls, and this probably could be the end.
It probably is a tough subject for Biden to even go to because of these conflicts. We know that his son also took a plane trip on his plane, the vice president's plane,
right.
when he went to China. And
yeah.
then he got $1 billion from the Chinese government?
Right.
His hedge fund?
There's a lot. Look, the left knows that Biden's son is a problem for him. This is why when Hillary Clinton was running, these stories first originated back when Hillary Clinton was trying to make sure that Biden didn't get in the race. So now that these have been resurrected, I don't know who came up with the scheme. Maybe there really is this whistleblower
yeah.
is not a partisan. I mean, we want to hear from that whistleblower, but it sure looks like the scheme has backfired. And this, like I said, I think this is probably the end of Biden's campaign.
End of his campaign.
I really do. I don't think, not that he's still formidable. He still has a block of support.
Yeah.
But if you look, his lead is basically down to zero. If you look what happened in Iowa now, it looks like Elizabeth Warren is in the lead.
Your colleague on the left, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, is tweeting out. She said, at this point, the bigger national scandal is the Democratic Party's refusal to impeach President Trump. It just seems like everything that comes out, they continue to move toward any pursuing of impeachment. And they're not looking at the real wrongdoing, which we've been covering for 2.5 years, what happened at the FISA court. What do you make of AOC's tweet?
Well, remember, she was put up by the socialists. Right to run. When she ran in the primary and beat a sitting Democrat in New York City, she was a socialist. So what do socialists do? They want full control. They want one-party control. So the only way to get one-party control right now is to impeach the president. So that's what they're trying to do. So the more I think that they're out there promoting this kind of craziness and silliness, I think the more the American people are going to be put off. And I think the higher likelihood that President Trump is reelected.
Meanwhile, I mentioned in the last half an hour with Senator Graham that there's this op-ed by Kim Strassel, Horowitz Speaks. You had Michael Horowitz testifying last week, not a word about it. What can you tell us about the FISA abuse and when we will see this Michael Horowitz report on FISA?
Well, this is going to be more evidence that's coming forward. So you had the Comey report. Now you have this report that that Horowitz is coming up with. I hear that it is very lengthy. Everybody forgets this is, you know, we were the ones who first, the House Intelligence Committee Republicans are the ones that brought this to everyone's attention.
Yes.
And then this is what got Horowitz investigating the FISA abuse. So we have already determined that there was FISA abuse. The question is does Horowitz come up with new evidence, more evidence that can then be used by the U.S. Attorney in Connecticut, Durham, who's been put in place by Attorney General Barr to come up with answers to questions that Mueller, Mueller never finished his report. There's so many people that we don't know about with Mueller that we need Durham to not only get to the bottom of, tell us exactly what happened.
Yeah.
And then what Horowitz should have evidence that can then be used to build criminal cases against people who lied to the FISA court. That's what we really want to see. The American people aren't going to have trust in these intelligence agencies until someone is put in jail. I just came back. I went and did an event out in Missouri for Congressman Billy Long. The question that I get as I'm going through airports, question I get at these events where I'm speaking publicly, everybody wants to know the same thing.
Yeah.
When is somebody going to pay the price for what they did? Are you really going to have a FISA court that operates like this? I don't think so.
Yeah.
And look, the FISA court has a responsibility, too. So I hope that it'll take Durham longer to do his investigation.
Yeah.
But you know who could really do something right now? The FISA court.
Yeah.
The FISA court, once they get Horowitz's evidence that he's going to provide, the FISA court needs to step in and hold some of these lawyers in contempt, because that will get action quick from people that will start to talk.
I want to take a short break, but you also have breaking news this morning because you've pinpointed one individual that we want to talk about. We've done a lot on him. We're going to come back and talk about